Hello students, with this video I will virtually demonstrate you the practical aiming production of fungal xylanases through submerged and solid state fermentation technique and enzyme SC. For this, these are the requirements that you have to prepare before the practical: pure culture of Aspergillus niger, mineral salt medium or Zepex Roxagar medium, oat powder, sterile petri plates, conical flask, laminar airflow, congorid, sodium chloride solution, cork borer, centrifuge machine, ammonium sulfate, spectrophotometer and distilled water. Coming to the principle, first we will discuss what are xylanase producing fungi. Filamentous fungi are particularly interesting producers of xylanases due to the fact they produce extracellular xylanases in the medium. Furthermore, xylanase level of fungal cultures are generally much higher than that of yeast and bacteria. So, the fungal cultures are best sources of xylanase production. In addition to xylanases, fungi are also responsible for production of some accessory xylonetic enzyme, which are necessary for debranching substituted xylans. So they are having substituted and supportive xylonetic activity also, so that they are good producers of xylanase enzyme. An important factor for efficient xylanase production is the choice of appropriate substrate, including either insoluble or soluble, as well as optimization of media composition, so that what kind of substrate we are providing for xylanase production and the conditions that we are providing for xylanase production are responsible for these are responsible factors for xylanase production by a particular fungi. Let us see the properties of xylanases. It's a class of hydrolytic enzyme. Its chemical classification number is EC3.2.1.8. And this is a type of hydrolytic enzyme which can hydrolyze straight polysaccharide beta-1,4 xylane in hemicellulosis, which is noteworthy component of secondary cell wall of the plants. Most of the xylanes are present in the cell wall of the plants. Xylane, the compound is mostly present in the lignocellulosic feedstocks from hemicellulosis, and it comprises a backbone of beta-1,4 linked xylopyranose residues and form an interface between lignin and other polysaccharide. This is the structure of normal xylane. It's a polymer linking with beta-1,4 linkage between the first and fourth hydrogen of the monomer. It gets hydrolyzed with the action of beta-1,4 xylanase enzyme and converted into the monomer, that is xylose. This xylanase enzyme have gained importance in the biotechnology and other industrial processes due to the potential of its various applications. It is applied in the textile industry for biopolishing of fabrics, mostly the denim fabrics. It is also useful in household industry laundry detergents for improving the fabric softness and brightness. It is also used in food, leather, paper, pulp industries, and fermentation of biomass for biofuel production also. It is also used in ruminant nutrition for improving the digestibility of the feed, and also the processing of fruit juices and delinking of paper. So these are the important applications for that the xylanase enzyme is gaining importance nowadays. Coming to the principle of fermentation, the growth of microorganisms, mostly here we are using fungi, on moist solid materials in the absence of free flowing water is called as solid state fermentation. In this process, xylanase is an inducible enzyme, and the xylane present in the substrate, solid substrate, either in the form of oatmeal or wheat bran, act as a good inducer for enzyme production. So the oat or wheat bran is the substrate which induces the production of xylane by the microorganism. Here in this case, we are using the fungal enzyme. Industrial production of enzyme and other substrate are also done by growing the microorganism in a submerged culture, broth culture. This is called as submerged state fermentation. In submerged cultures, the cultures are allowed to grow under controlled condition in the degree of aeration, pH, temperature, as well as the other environmental conditions are controlled, and it can be controlled further, and the optimum growth of organism can be achieved. So we are having two methods of fermentation. One is solid state fermentation based on the solid materials without free flowing water, and other is the submerged fermentation in which the substrate is present in the broth culture under the optimized condition. Coming to the procedure part. Procedure can be divided into subheadings. Very first step is selective isolation of xylanase producing fungi. For selective isolation of xylanase producing fungi, we have to prepare mineral salt medium, MSM medium, with this composition. 1 liter medium can be prepared, added with xylose. The fungi are grown in this medium, and properly growing, actively growing fungal cultures are isolated. And these fungal cultures then subjected to primary screening for xylanase production. After 5 days of incubation in this mineral salt medium, the culture plates are flooded with 0.01% of the Congo Red solution. This method was given by Teether and Wood in 1982. The plates are allowed to stand for 10 to 15 minutes and de-stained with 1% sodium chloride solution. The plates are observed for zone of hydrolysis or zone of clearance and measured in centimeters or millimeters. The zone of clearance indicates the absence of xylose and unstained area with Congo Red. Next step is secondary screening. The cultures showing positive for xylanase production are subjected to secondary screening. For this, the culture medium is prepared and fungal culture is subjected to both solid state fermentation and submerged fermentation for growth. Under solid state fermentation technique, we have to take 40 gram of substrate. Either we can take wheat powder or oat powder, whole oat powder, moist with MSM medium or Zepex Stocks medium can also be used. The mixture is autoclaved for 121 degrees centigrade for 15 minutes and inoculated with the test fungi. Here we are using Aspergillus niger culture. Incubate the flask for 28 degrees, 7 days, for 7 days. Harvest the enzyme by filtration through cheesecloth, followed by centrifugation at 10,000 RPM for 20 minutes at 4 degrees centigrade. Prepare agarose gel plates and make well in the center of plate with the help of cork borer and load the well with the harvested enzyme. Incubate the plates for 24 hours and add Congo Red after 24 hours and wait for 10 minutes and de-stain with 1% NaCl solution if required. Observations are recorded for presence or absence of zone of clearance around the well. For submerged state fermentation technique, you have to prepare MSM broth with 1% brickwood xylan as a substrate, as a carbon source or as a xylanose source. Incubate the agar plugs, incubate with agar plus of 0.5 millimeter size of fungal cultures. The broth medium is inoculated with fungal cultures and incubated for 7 days. The culture flask can be incubated under shaking condition. If the shaker is not available, twice or thrice in a day the flask should be shaken and incubated. Otherwise, if you are having the shaker, orbital shaker, the shaker is adjusted to 150 RPM speed and then incubate it for 7 days. After 7 days of incubation, the filtrate is filtered with Wattman number 1 filter paper. And then the filtrate is again subjected to centrifugation for 8000 RPM at 4 degrees centigrade for 10 minutes. The supernatant is collected as enzyme source of xylanase activity. Again, you have to confirm the presence of xylanase in the supernatant. Prepare agarose gel plates, make well and fill the wells with enzyme extract, crude enzyme. Incubate the plates and after incubation of 24 hours, add Congo Red for indicator and destain with 1% NaCl solution. Again, observation is recorded for presence or absence of zone of clearance or clear zone around the well. Next step is purification of enzyme. The harvested enzyme after centrifugation is need to be purified. The purification is due for removal of contaminants. The contaminants may be in the form of unspent media and ingredients or other soluble compounds which need to be removed from the supernatant. For this, you have to make a large amount of culture and inoculate the culture with sufficient inoculum and incubate for 2 to 4 days. After incubation, the centrifuge the culture and collect the supernatant. The supernatant is containing the crude enzyme is to be purified with saltation technique, that is addition of ammonium sulfate saturated solution. After salting out, the enzyme protein is get precipitated and then separated by the centrifugation at 10,000 RPM for 15 minutes. For this, if you are available with cooling centrifuge, it is advisable to use cooling centrifuge for this purpose, or the room temperature should not be exceed to 40 or 45 degree. Next step is confirmation of enzyme activity. The enzyme activity after purification of enzyme pellet. The enzyme pellet is suspended in distilled water or any other suitable buffer and confirm for the presence of xylanase activity. The confirmation is done through secondary screening method. This pure enzyme after confirmation is ready for estimation. The estimation is done on the basis of quantitative method, and further the enzyme properties can be characterized through SDS page or protein gel electrophoresis. For enzyme assay, the enzyme is subjected to substrate in vitro condition and the amount of hydrolytic product is estimated spectrophotometrically. For this, you have to prepare a reaction mixture by mixing 0.9 ml of 1% Brickwood xylane. This Brickwood xylane is a standard substrate for estimation. This is added with sodium citrate buffer and pH is maintained 5.3 with 1 ml of purified enzyme. This reaction mixture is having enzyme, substrate and buffer. This is called as reaction mixture. This reaction mixture is incubated for various temperatures. For this, I have selected some higher degree of temperature, but otherwise 30 degree, 40 degree and 50 degree. For this, I have prepared for some thermophilic activity testing. Otherwise, we can incubate the enzyme reaction mixture at 30, 35, 40, 45 degree and so on. After 5 minutes, add 1.5 ml of 3,5-dinitrosalicylic acid, that is called as DNS solution, and the mixture is boiled for 5 minutes. It is recommended that in this reaction mixture, you have to collect, separate 5 ml solution and add after each 5 minutes or after each 10 minutes, you have to add DNS solution and boil for 5 minutes. And the remaining is again incubated for next 5 minutes, and for this is repeated for 5 or 6 times so that you can have a complete enzymatic reaction. After boiling with DNS solution, the reaction mixture is converted into a colored solution as per the conversion of xylane into monomer, that is glucose. Read the color with the help of spectrophotometer at 540 nanometers. Quantify the amount of reducing sugar liberated by the hydrolysis of xylanase enzyme using xylose as a standard. One unit of xylanase is defined as amount of enzyme that liberated 1 micromole of xylose equivalent to per minute under SA conditions. Plot the graph with readings of optical density obtained in spectrophotometer. This is the picture. The Petri plate showing primary screening. The fungal culture is growing in the center of Petri plate and showing a zone of clearance around the growing colony, in contrast with the Congorid area, which is showing the presence of xylane substrate. The second picture is showing secondary screening. Here, the wells are cut, 3 wells are cut, and the culture filtrate after centrifugation is poured, filled in this well, and after incubation, a clear zone of clearance is showing here, indicating the presence of production of xylanase enzyme in the supernatant after centrifugation. Observations are recorded in this table. This is for primary screening. Here we can write the name of culture. That is, in this case, we have already decided to start with practical with Aspergillus niger. So no need of adding the code of culture. And confirmation of zone of clearance, that is positive or highly positive. Under secondary screening, we have to record the solid state fermentation and submerged fermentation result separately. The size of clear zone observed under solid state fermentation or submerged fermentation in millimeters or centimeters. We can compare both the methods with common organism. So we can conclude whether Aspergillus niger in this the present condition is suitable to produce maximum xylanase enzyme under solid state fermentation or submerged fermentation. So we can conclude that which method, either solid state or submerged fermentation technique, is suitable for this particular Aspergillus niger strain. With this, we can compare other fungal cultures and conclude that either solid state or submerged fermentation conditions are suitable for xylanase production under industrial level. For enzyme assay, we have to prepare a standard curve. These are the hypothetical concentrations that I have prepared for the calculation process. 0.1 molar, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5 and 0.6 molar. These are the standard series concentration. So we have to prepare a standard series of xylane and then processed as well, and optical density is measured. The readings are as like this. The unknown enzyme that we have cultivated Aspergillus niger, either solid state or submerged fermentation condition, are subjected in the same way, and the reaction mixture is treated as well, and this optical density has obtained. Now, with the help of this standard series, we can easily find out the concentration of unknown enzyme solution, and enzyme units can be converted with the conversion factor. With this, this is blue line is the standard curve that we have plotted with the help of these optical density readings, and the yellow line is indicating the optical density of unknown, and with that we can calculate the concentration of unknown. Now depict your result in the form of number of positive cultures if we are using more than one culture, or again, if we are using more than one culture, so name of highly positive, moderate positive and least positive cultures. then confirm the xylanase activity in each culture, and finally the result of enzyme assay in which amount of enzyme units per ml of enzyme solution. The pure enzyme which we have suspended in the suitable buffer or in a water solution is act as enzyme solution, and that enzyme solution is used for preparation of reaction mixture. The final calculation is done in the amount of enzyme units as we calculated with standard curve graph per ml of enzyme solution. Interpret your result as a source of microorganism and probability of xylanase production. Whether this Aspergillus niger culture is having potential for good xylanase producer or not, and we can compare with other fungal cultures and same Aspergillus niger culture from different geographical area. With this, some precautions should be necessary. All inoculations and the microbiological activity should be done carefully. Care should be taken while handling the centrifuge and also the spectrophotometer, and all observations should be recorded very carefully, so there should be no mistake or no misrecording during the experimentation. For this, that's all for this. Thank you.